How you doing? How you been? What's going on? What's good? How you getting in? Body getting funny. What's going on, people?
What's up, people? Another day of another day of another day that we call Saturday. Anyway, that being said, what's going on, people? Hopefully, everybody's doing anything as far as being safe on this freezing cold day as of Saturday. You know, I want to talk to you about something. There's a lot of things that go through my mind, and I always try to keep it positive, you know what I mean? But the thing is that I want to talk to you about the passable transsexuals and the ones that are not passable. Now, there are a lot of girls out here that take a lot of hormones and stuff because they want to be passable, and they want to be basically walk through life like myself, that nobody will pay us any mind, but at the end of the day, we are just not passable. And I understand people are going to say, me, but to me, I'm not. And I have to stand in my truth. I appreciate you giving me the love, but I know what I know. And the thing about it is that I learned within myself is that the reason why me, like a lot of my other sisters, are not passable, because that's not what you were born here. You were born here to stand out. And let's say, well, Ray, what does that mean? I was born here to stand out. Now, there are girls out here that are very passable, that you wouldn't know they're trans, I wouldn't know they're trans, and they go through life and stuff like that, and they just move forward. Now, the girls like myself who are not passable, who do not get that thing as far as just going through life, people not know, it is for a reason. Because you are here to save souls. And you said, well, Raven, how am I going to save souls? Because the simple fact of the matter is that someone is like you that's going through something, and they're not passable, and they're not getting that passable status. And you, as a person that's being strong, being true to yourself, showing them, look, girl, I'm unbothered. You're going on hills, you don't even care, you know you're not passable. But the thing about it is that you don't care. And let me tell you why. Because you have confidence, you have self-assurance. And what everybody done said to you, you already done heard it before. And you actually heard about people that really mattered to you. So anyone else that has something negative or something very, you know, to tear your self-esteem down, it doesn't matter. And that thing right there that you're possessing as you walk down the streets and everything, unbothered, you know, do what you need to do as far as your daily activities, buying clothes, shopping, going to work, whatever the case may be, there is somebody else that doesn't have that strength that you possess. And you are actually helping them. They say, well, look at her. I know what she is, but look at her. And they'll stand back and just look at you. Here it is, you just unbothered doing tickety your daily activities. And they're watching you. They say, this girl is walking through life unbothered. If she could do it, I could do it. I could live in my truth and be who I am. Because I'm looking at somebody who is a hero to me. And they don't even know it. And you may say, well, Raven, that's just them and stuff like that. No, 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 no. It doesn't stop there, honey. There is a woman who has low self-esteem. I see her as female. And she watches you walk by. She has no confidence because she's been broken down as well. People don't put her down, call up kinds of names, something. Because this is a thing we forget. See, as females go through the same thing as well as transgender women. And so as well as some men. But the thing about it is that you're so powerful, you don't even know the power that you possess, because in your mind you're like, well, I'm not passable, I'm not passable, I'm not going to get, because you were not born there to do it. You was not born here to do that. You were needed to stand out. You're going to help so many people that you have no idea, that's never even going to walk up to you. Some will, but some won't, because they don't possess the confidence that you have. That's why they can't walk up to you. But they're going to keep that thought they saw you, and it's going to play in their mind. You know, when everyone is away and no one is around, that thought of you runs through their mind. And that day they decide they're going to go out and stand in their truth, that thought that you gave them, let them go, I'm on my way. And the thing about it is that a lot of times you may not know this, but you're actually, and this is a female. See, as a female, how powerful you are. She's a woman who want to try different things, but she's afraid because of what people are going to say. She get a little whistle, you walking by, and she go, oh, and she's unbothered. And she's going to sit back and she's going to watch. She gonna say, she got confidence. Then she doesn't care what about it. Look at her. So now she's thinking to herself, well, she could do it, then why can I do it? Now this is the day and stuff like that. I'm just saying as far as the negative way, because some people say, well, you may be going out there and people are in trouble. No. Everybody has to do everything at their time, at their speed. Nobody does everything the way somebody thinks they should do it. It has to be done your way in order for it to work. Anything in life has to be done your way. It can't because I'm telling you, it can't because another girl telling you. That's the reason why I'm making this video, let you know that you sit back as a non-passable woman. You sit back and you actually helping people who did not have the strength. And at that time, they feel as though they have the strength to move forward. They go, you know what? That thought of playing in mind, where they're standing by this outfit, or they're standing by this hair, or they're standing by this job, and they don't feel as they got that confidence to go think of you. And sometimes they could kind of, what they call that word when someone think about you so much that they kind of feel you inside. I'm going to think about it through the video and stuff like that. Channel. They channel you. They channel your spirit. They channel that confidence. They channel when they go. They walk out, they finally be themselves. And you are so much of a power person that no one is giving that accolades as far as that. So as of today, I feel as though I need to be shared this with you. Here is a man that's very short who gets upset because of the fact of the matter is he wants to be taller. And he always being compared to someone else. Now he gets a little upset, a little agitated, which be the ones a lot of times have the most smile. And I'm not saying every man, I'm not saying every woman, I'm saying every trans woman. But if it relates to you, understand what I'm saying. You know, and the thing about it is that you still get that support for him. He sits there and say, well, I see this girl, she doing love in her life, she don't care what nobody say. So you go ahead and do what you want to do. You know, you're so powerful, but no one is telling you that. So as of today and Saturday, I have to share this information with you to let you know how powerful you are. You are born to be different. You were born to stand out. I understand you want to fit in because you have your good and bad days. Like I said, makes you human. But at the end of the day, you're saving souls and you don't even know it. You're doing so much good and don't even know it. You're helping so many people which don't even know. And when I say this, I'm saying it in a positive manner for the people who will try to find any way they can to turn it into something very negative. And for the people who know how I'm talking to you, you know where I'm coming from. So you may be at the point in your life, you know, you've just feel everything you try to do just fell because of who you are and your self-esteem get torn down. And, you know, you look, think of that one girl with that confidence. Say, well, she wasn't allowed us. She wasn't allowed us. She just walked through the beach. She don't care. She may have some little extra in the pocket, but just get somebody act up. Because those who are not passable, we stay prepared. Some girls get ready, but we stay ready. Because the one thing about us as far as transition, many of us, not saying every, I'm not a passable girl, but I'm talking about myself. When you never fit in, you just never fit in. So for the girls who always fit in through life and stuff like that, and you know, you always had that thing and then you transition to that, all of a sudden you don't fit in, it's because that's something new to you. These are certain levels that you have to get to in order to adapt to that. For the girls like me who's never been accepted, we don't have to get to those levels because we came out the womb like that. And we, as a child, we're going to unaccept it, and we learn a defense mechanism that makes sure we stay strong. And whenever you come for us, we already have our armor on you, on us, whatever way we want us, whatever way you want to handle it, we will handle it. And the thing about it, when it comes down to a lot of girls like us, you know, who are not passive and stuff like that, and, you know, we stand in our truth and stuff like that, we possess a strength that's way stronger than many people know. We're stronger than, we're so strong mentally. Sometimes physically too, but we can handle a lot. That does not make us human, because we hurt at times too. You know, because we often can get hurt. Sometimes we don't want to hear it, because you know what that makes us? That makes us human. And sometimes we do want to have those good days like everyone else, but we're not perfect, just like you. So some days you're going to have those bad days, but then you could go back to that one person in your mind that you could draw that strength from and say, you know what? I'm going to be okay. Now, I'm saying this as far as, you know, information sharing with you, passport, because there are some girls out here who just don't feel like they can make it, and they need some type of confidence or someone to look up to say, well, you know what? I could do this. I know her. I know how she is. Uh-huh. She did it. She had no problem. She just walked through the beat. She paid people dust, and that's where I need to get to. Like I said before, it takes steps. It takes levels. You will get there. Do not rush it. Everything takes time. You just see your way through it, and once you get there, and I'm talking to the non-passable, I'm talking to the passable, the girls who are not passable, know they're not going to be passive, but they want to live their life in their true authenticity instead of trying to do things for other people.
You want to stand in your truth.
So I just wanted to stand with you and give you this information as far as on a Saturday. So you can stay positive, stay strong, and remember one thing, and like all my non-passable women out here, the reason why you're not passable is because you're saving souls and you don't even know it. You're saving so many souls that people don't even know that you're saving souls. But I guarantee you, I'm letting you know. Because sometimes people can't walk into it, they don't possess the confidence that you have, that I have. We have that confidence. So non-passable to non-passable, honey, we stand strong. And we knock down a lot of doors. We do a lot of things other people wish they could do. We do it. At the end of the day, my non-passable sisters and all my sisters, I want to let you know that I love you. And of course, my non-passable ones. And this is my way of thinking. If you feel as though you're passable, you're not, I'm not saying that. I'm not pointing fingers. If the message is to you, take it, embrace it, and move forward with it, and save souls. If it's not to you, then it wasn't meant for you. Anyway, that being said, I just wanted to share this message with you on this first Saturday. And I want to let you know that I love you. And I want to thank you for watching. Catch the rain.